Hi, we're Tony and Chelsea Northrup, and we're back from a couple of weeks off for the holidays.
Chelsea. That was nice.
Yeah. Though for us, we practically work in retail because, well, a lot of people wanted to buy our books, which was exciting.
Yeah.
Spent a lot of time shipping stuff, though. So thanks to everybody who bought our books, all the new readers and viewers.
Our readers and viewers are amazing because our publishing company is just me, Tony, Justin, and very recently Siobhan, and we are beating some of the biggest publishers in the world. So you're supporting a super small business and you're really supporting our dream. It means so much to us. Thank you.
Yeah, we're doing our best to keep up.
Yeah.
Well, tell them who is bringing the show to them.
This episode is brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform for creating a fast and easy online portfolio or professional website. But really, Squarespace is great. We both host our portfolios there. It's really clean, it's professional looking, the design is great, and it's affordable. So you can go to squarespace.com and you can get a free trial for 14 days. You don't need a credit card or anything. And if you like it, you can get 10% off by going to squarespace.com/Tony and using the coupon code PHOTONEWS. And they have really cool logo design there. And it's free.
Yeah.
If you have a Squarespace portfolio, if you don't, it's $10.
You'll see Chelsea stole some of their iconography from ...2014, and I meant to open this, and I didn't. I'll open it right now.
Tigar, who is chatting with y'all right now, probably saying really inappropriate things, like I love. And Susie, I don't think Susie watches the live show, but we recognize their pictures right away, so congratulations, guys.
Here we go. That's not theirs, but after that first one, they were in second and third place here. That's Susie Mead's picture, just gorgeous, and that's Tigar's self-portrait one. Both really striking work, and they've put a lot of work into it, so really proud of you guys. You guys do amazing stuff. Today's portrait theme is portraits. We're pretty open-ended about it. Whatever, we're not gonna, just make it a portrait, make it something deliberate. Not a snapshot, not a candid, but a portrait, something you put thought into.
Let's not stretch the definition.
One picture per person. What's this, Jels?
Justin was telling me about this picture. It's Peter Ensred. He chats with Justin. He's an STP reader, and this picture is amazing. It's got almost 400 likes in our STP private community, and I just thought that the composition was incredible. The lines in this picture are beautiful. It's perfect.
Yeah.
It's incredible.
This picture is perfect.
Blows my mind.
Any fringing to get that kind of detail on the stars is really amazing. Yeah. Wow.
I know. You
can see the reflection of the stars in the water. What a still, perfect, clear night, great location. Wow. Thanks, Peter. Fantastic work.
Thank you, Peter.
Talk about Yuan Din. Oh, man, I didn't get the video ready for you, Justin, but...
I saw this and I was like, what is he, like some kind of ninja?
You Google his name and you can look up the video. He's just a photographer who constantly does these kinds of spins. He's from Vietnam.
I've seen that guy.
You have? What is his deal? Why is he doing this?
He finds that it helps him get interesting angles and such.
This seems like a real gimmick.
I would think the bigger part of it would be that he'd be getting interesting reactions and expressions out of people, but all of his shots seems to be just like very posed and people not looking at him. So I guess he just does it for his own benefit, spark your creativity.
They're like, just don't look at him, don't encourage him. He's just like doing somersaults all around.
We all have different things that we do to get some extra creativity, right?
People keep saying it's cutting out.
Yeah.
The sound is cutting out?
Yeah, this Adam is behaving a little different.
There's something wrong?
I'm getting used to it though.
Over the holiday we redid our studio and we moved some things around, so it might take us a little while to get it right, so sorry about that. We'll be working on it.
Yeah, new stuff always breaks.
That was deep.
I don't know why the slide is in here, but we did post a review of the A7 Mark II.
Mm-hmm.
If you guys have any follow-up questions, I know we're... Mirrorless cameras is something that's always really controversial because we've tested every single one of the top-end cameras, and we don't, as far as tracking moving subjects, none of them have kept up with even the base model DSLRs, but every owner says, oh, mine does fine. And yeah. So I feel like we need to go into a little more detail about
it. Well, I want to just because there's a whole community of mirrorless lovers, and they just like hate us because they think that we're biased, but we're really trying very hard not to be biased. So if you think that there's something we're doing wrong, write us and tell us, and don't call us names when you do it, maybe. I don't know. But we want to prove you right. So give us any test that you want us to do, basically. Tell us what you think we're doing wrong. We want to have good information for people.
Yeah, and I think the biggest difference is that we always compare things side by side. And most people just
have one camera
and they use it and they're happy with it. And that's something I try to keep in mind. And we even talked about at the end of the video, we said, hey, it's not as good at focusing as a DSLR, but is it good enough? And we both said, yeah, for most things it's good enough. Well, but people still get mad.
We didn't just say it was good enough. We said we really loved it. We wouldn't use it to go take wildlife photos. If I had to go take pictures of an eagle, I wouldn't count on that thing when I have, you know, the 7D Mark II. That would be crazy. I don't think anyone would.
Well, that's how you know we're not biased, because we have the 7D Mark II and the A7 and the A7S, and we have all these cameras. And so what do we pick up when we're not on camera? That's a good test, because we don't care. We have it all sitting there.
I will say, we always pick the Sonys when we're going out to dinner or going out on the town, and we just might see something and we think we might want to take pictures.
Yeah, for
it's so
Christmas
light. It's
and
incredible.
The family holidays and stuff, that's just what I carried, because it was perfect for that kind of thing. But for sports,
but
I did bring it to a mad soccer game a couple of times. It was terrible.
Yeah.
It's just, that's not where it excels.
Could you get it? And then we always have the thing where someone says, well, it works fine for me. They'll send us their portfolio. There's some great pictures in there, but maybe like most are not what I would call in focus. So people have a different definition of in focus. And that's rough. What are you going to say to somebody? Like, I don't think any of your pictures are acceptable. But
if you're happy with it, just keep moving forward.
Yeah, just keep going.
And don't watch camera reviews about cameras you already own.
Yeah, you're going
to end up frustrated. We're waiting for this to show up, but I wanted to tell you a bit of news. I find this really exciting. The Chinese manufacturer Yongno is manufacturing a $40 50mm f1.8 lens. Now, this is funny because they've made a competitor to the very cheapest lens on the market, which is the Canon 50mm f1.8. It initially was available on eBay for $40, but it was such a hit that now it's costing between like $60 and $80 on eBay.
That makes
the price
sense.
Has like doubled. But I'm sure if you wait around long enough, it'll be available for $40 again. We have one coming, and we'll compare it to the Canon 50mm f1.8. They are supposed to be making a Nikon version. So we'll see. I'll be excited about that, because Nikon doesn't have a super cheap autofocus lens that will autofocus with the low-end bodies. I'll be here soon.
Cool.
Another 50mm lens that we have here is the Metacon 50mm
f0.95. Wait, that's not the brand, is it?
It seems to be known under two names, and this seems to happen with Chinese manufacturers a lot.
This is like
Zhongyi or Metacon. If you look on Amazon, it's listed under both names. So I don't know the relationship. They kind of need to straighten out their branding. It is an amazing lens. It's manual focus only, and with shallow depth of field, that's not a great combination.
Yeah, but it looks really cool. I took a picture of our dog, Cowbrow, and his nose was in focus, but his feet were so blurred. And it's a really neat effect.
Yeah, you almost get that kind of tilt-shift effect because the depth of field is so strikingly shallow that everything looks kind of miniaturized.
Yeah, it is kind of tilt-shift, but you know what? Even with the focus peaking, it's so hard to get anything in focus. It's
you'll just have to take a lot of shots, refocusing a little
but
bit at a
time. But it seems worth it because it's really cool. It's different.
And I put it on the A7S and took it out at night and wide open. You can, like, see the universe.
You can see the universe.
You can walk outside and see five stars in the sky.
Yeah, but we also lost Cowbrow, and you just took that out like night vision. You were like, I see Cowbrow.
Yes. It's such a fun toy. I make everybody pick it up, and everybody goes outside and looks at the stars.
And they're like,
oh, my God.
So many.
Yeah, it's really, anyway, it's really, really cool to be gathering that much light, especially with
the A7S,
which is great. Another new piece of gear that we got in over the holidays is the Steadicam Curve. I think a viewer sent us this. It's a little Steadicam for a GoPro. And I think these are always a little bit hard to use. But
really? Does it work? Justin, did you try it?
I took it out of the box, so I don't think we've had a chance to play with it yet.
I played with it for like 5 seconds.
And is that because it wasn't fun?
No, I just didn't have much time to play with it.
All right.
Well, Steadicams require the equivalent of like a master's degree of study.
I have the steadiness of an elderly woman.
But once you get them, they work pretty well. This was a Christmas present that we got for Justin.
Why is it here? Did we steal it back?
Yeah, I took it out of the box because I wanted
to
show it off.
You'll never treat her like we do.
But I just think it's so cool. It looks like...
It's so big.
Like a 1980s Decepticon or something. Like it would transform into something.
I feel like I should be able to play video games on the back.
Yes. It is a film camera, 35mm film. It exposes 2 negatives at a time. But with 4 lenses, so it's actually taking 4 shots spread across 2 negatives. And then you can send the film in to the camera manufacturer or some company, and they turn it into one of those like little 3D things that you hold and you turn back and forth.
Yes,
you know,
yes.
Look at from different angles.
What do they call those? I don't know.
Justin, do you have any idea? No?
Hologram, but not really.
Yeah, something. Anyway,
yeah.
Super cool. It's under $20.
Why'd you just tell Justin? That was his Christmas present.
Sorry to ruin it for you, Justin. CES, the Consumer Electronics Show.
Oh, we talked about going there, but then we didn't.
Yeah, we did not go to CES.
Well, because we said that we were like, we want to go to Las Vegas, but then we were like, it would be full of nerds.
Yeah, I want to be the nerdiest guy there. It might not be possible during CES. They announce a lot of new gear all the time, and this year I actually was kind of disappointed. I didn't see anything that really... felt like wow to me.
Well, Nikon had a new camera and lens, right?
Right.
Here
so
we go.
They announced the Nikon D5500.
And you know what amazed me? It had an articulating touchscreen.
Finally.
Like you've been talking about
this
for so long.
It's like they're listening to us.
I don't think they care
I'm gonna
about
take
us
complete
at
credit
all.
For
they
this.
Won't even answer our emails. They're like, I don't know
no,
who
Nikon's
you are,
good
but don't
this.
Talk to me anymore.
Nikon oh, sends us stuff. Yeah.
Oh, it's Canon that gives us the cold shoulder.
Yeah. Canon's
well,
not friendly.
Either way, your dream came true. What else? You're like the Nostradamus of photography. What else are you looking forward to?
They also announced the Nikon 300mm f/4, and this is an important lens in the Nikon lineup because it's like the cheapest wildlife lens that they have. And yeah, it is expensive, and you kind of need to slap a teleconverter on it if you're going to get anywhere near a reasonable wildlife range, like a 1.4x teleconverter. But because it's prime, you tend to get much sharper results than you do with any of the zooms. So they're updating kind of an old classic that 300mm f/4 prime has been really used commonly. Anyway, super lightweight thanks to some phase Frenzel design, which is just like those old Frenzel lenses that you're familiar with. Lighter and shorter. And Fuji announced a 16-55mm f/2.8 lens, just a faster kind of zoom lens. It matches well to the
wow.
X-T1. Because it has a fixed aperture, they can put the aperture ring on the lens itself. And one of our gripes with the X-T1s is the kit lens that came with it had a variable aperture, therefore you couldn't use the ring. Really, you couldn't see the aperture as you were dialing it in, and that made the whole camera more difficult to use. So I think this is a great match to the X-T1. sdp.io/f16 if you want to check it out. $1,100, pretty expensive.
That seems steep.
Yeah, all the Fuji gear, once you put it in equivalent terms, ends up being really expensive, but if you're a Fuji
don't
person,
talk about those
it's super
equivalent
cool.
Terms.
I know people get upset about
the
that.
Rage.
Okay, it's f/2.8. We'll just keep it simple. What's this, Chels?
Someone just said my name is an anagram for the corpulent rash, and they asked me if I knew that.
Yeah, you shouldn't be reading comments.
Oh, I just that one. This Facebook. Has when you go to upload a picture now that they enhance your picture because they say they want their users to share images that look more like their memories. So here's an example of what it does. And I'm like, the only difference I see is that her jeans look very, very blue. It's like, oh, I'll always remember how blue her jeans looked that day.
Yeah, they upped the saturation. I can see they brought the shadows up too because you see more texture in their shirts.
In her hair, but I'm so not impressed. And this is such old technology, right? Like. They're talking about it like it's incredibly cool. Twitter has, you can edit your pictures on Instagram and stuff. It's
well,
not.
But Facebook is doing it kind of involuntarily and automatically. And I just can't imagine why they're doing that because our phones do it all the time. Like most people's Snapchats, like if you need it, then it's going to do it anyway.
Well, that's what I mean. I don't think it's that I'm not impressed. This was a big story, and I just wanted to share it so I could say, Chelsea's not impressed.
Okay. That's noted.
I thought this was hilarious, because I just did a video on logos, and Randy Johnson, the famous pitcher who threw a fastball and hit a bird and killed it, is now a sports photographer, and his logo is a dead bird. So bravo, Randy Johnson. You made me laugh today.
I love everything that Randy Johnson's got going on in that photo there.
Those tight buns.
Yeah, and that just Austin stash and what seems to be a big mullet.
The logo's really good. There's like a circle reminiscent of the baseball.
Yeah.
It's not too graphic. I love it.
I would have done a little logo of his face with the hair and the mustache. I don't know. It just seems awesome.
What's in the cup?
Tell them what this is, Chels.
We'll go to the next slide. I have a recipe. Campari and IPA spritzer. Tony's always drinking IPA, so you just add a little bit of Campari to it, and voila, you have a disgusting drink. Did you like it, Tony?
Yeah, I actually went in for a refill, though.
Oh, Justin,
I totally misunderstood the ratios, because I thought it was 1-to-1.
Oh, and so you have something much different.
It's
in your
like
cup.
4-to-1, 4 ounces of beer to 1 ounce of Campari, and so I'm probably going to be real drunk.
Oh. Good Lord, you are on your way to a good time. This is the photo and the recipe are from thekitchen.com, kitchen without an E, and I thought it was a really nice picture too. I abandoned this recipe because I thought it was gross. So Justin's cup has beer in it and mine has coffee with Bailey's Irish cream.
Oh, good for you, keeping you awake.
Mm-hmm. Chit chat.
Maybe we should take a moment and go look at some pictures first. We've been talking for a long time. You want to go right into chit chat?
No, you're right. We should do what we said we would do.
These are some pictures that people sent to us while we were offline. And I just wanted to go over the thumbnails and see things that are cool. This one strikes me right away. Just a gorgeous, what looks like a sunrise picture. I love that you can see a few city lights down
here.
Oh
my goodness.
Yeah, gorgeous, right?
Good Lord.
Look at this lady.
Whoa.
She's got some feathers going on.
I want that outfit. Nip slip, though.
Yeah, that's a spectacular outfit. I love the background
actually,
blur.
Oh, actually, whole vagina exposed. Slip.
Okay, just move on.
I hate when that happens.
It happens to all of us
I
sometimes.
I hate it. Like, you're just standing there and then, boom!
Toucan.
Justin likes that. You've had experience with that. I like the the Airedale. Those are my favorite.
Yeah, he's really cute. Locked focus on the eyes, really good.
So cute.
Nicely done. Okay, so I'll do an import. I recognize that guy.
That's
we know him or something.
Jenny from the block. Really, a J-Lo joke made you laugh? That Campari really is strong.
It just seemed like an unlikely guess. I actually think you're wrong, Chels. Okay, so we're going to import pictures that people have submitted live. These are your pictures. We'll take a quick look at them.
How about the second guy? The one with the hat? He's handsome.
Could be a little underexposed. Maybe tone down the flash a little bit. I would crop a little deeper into his hat.
But then...
Handsome fella. This was the first portrait.
A little too smooth for me. There's something very smoothie.
Oh, you think they've done some processing on the skin and it was a little bit much?
Yeah.
I feel like they cut a little too deep into the hairline.
Oh, like
don't you feel like the ratio
forehead?
Is off a little bit? This is a
Let's
time.
Let's bring up the crop lines. And
yeah, I like to kind of use the rule of thirds and put the eyes right along this top line here and then have a balance that the distance between the eyes and the top of the frame and the chin and the bottom of the frame is a little more equal. Also, if you guys
good
don't know.
Good expression and pose, though. I like that.
There's a teeth whitening adjustment brush in Lightroom, and you know, her teeth are fine, but everybody needs a little bit of teeth whitening just because we're so used to seeing people with perfect teeth on TV.
I always say it's because we're American.
Yeah.
Once I edited a picture of you and everyone was like, why are you making his teeth whiter? I was like, we live in ridiculous standards as Americans. Everyone has to be a Crest commercial.
We have a Lightroom book out if you want to learn more about adjustment brushes and such, but that's an easy fix to make. I love this picture.
Yeah, that's such a nice picture.
Yeah, what a great natural expression. It almost feels candid, but it's clearly a nice planned out shot. I wouldn't make any adjustments to that at all. Candid shot.
I love the baby on the log.
It is really cute, though. It to me, it almost feels like, it doesn't feel like a portrait because their eyes are somewhere else.
Yeah, it's more of like a candid shot. His little fingers are cut off.
Ooh. Yeah, the cropping's a little weird there. This looks like somebody is standing over the shoulder of a wedding photographer. You know how people do this when you're shooting a wedding? There's always somebody with their camera standing like right behind and beside the wedding photographer trying to take pictures.
Stealing your shots.
And I'll say that because it looks like her eye contact is a little bit off frame. And eyes are funny. Like if they're not looking directly at the camera, it looks really odd. They can be 3 inches off to the side and it looks really weird.
I always ruin your shots because people always look at me instead of you.
Yeah. Well, you never stop jumping around, so that could be it. Now, her eyes are off frame, but it feels deliberate, so it feels completely natural.
Yeah, the lighting is really beautiful.
Yeah, that is really nice lighting.
I love it.
Yeah, great
I
shot.
Love
I love
negative
the dark
space. Oh,
background.
You too?
Yeah. Mm. We agree on this.
Oh my gosh, that baby is killing me. So cute. Look
yeah, at, he is really cute.
This is really adorable.
Okay, so we have kind of a glamour shot here. The eyes were definitely brightened up quite a bit, and I think I would actually prefer to see deeper shadows. What do you think, John?
Yeah, I think that they're a little bit, can I zoom?
Yeah.
They're a little bit over-processed.
Yeah.
My advice is always to dial it back about 20% when you're done.
Yeah, it is common to brighten the eyes. I think we just went a little too far here. Again, we have like mixed eye contact. He seems to be looking right at the camera. She seems to be looking off somewhere else.
I think this guy's great, so I'm just gonna.
Oh, no. This is the photo that he'll put at match.com after they split up. It's still his best shot. Gotta crop the wife out. Awesome. Interesting crop here. Beautiful. Nice focus on the eye. Yeah, it's pretty close to precise. I love it. I can't think of anything else to say. A lot of character in this shot.
You know what I'm going to do.
Yeah, this one deserves some black and white. I even feel like we should, looking at the histogram here, I can see it's a little underexposed, and especially you notice it in black and white. So I'm going to try to drop the overall exposure some, but still include some whites in there. I think this is actually a time when you can introduce some grain. So go down to the effects and just add a little grain to it.
Oh, whoa. I've never seen you do that.
So this is a deliberate portrait using on-camera flash for fill flash. Mm-hmm. And that is something we recommend. It's always better to get it off-camera if you can, but on-camera is often better than no catch light at all. And it really did bring her eyes out a little bit.
I like the rim lighting around her little fur collar and her hair.
Yeah, they did everything we say, which is if you're in the sunlight, to put the sun behind your subject, because you never want the sun in the person's face, and it just makes the light so much better.
Yeah.
I am a fan of cropping into the hairline a little bit.
I prefer it the other way, but...
Really prefer it wider?
Yeah, but the one thing I don't like is that Tweety Bird.
Oh, yeah, kids always have big logos, but, kids. You know, maybe it's an important part of her character, like maybe that means something. Maybe she's always associated with
Tweety.
Maybe
she just wants to take that damn hat off like our
scurry.
Kid does. Wearing her stupid
underwear. Scurry. I like the mood of the shot and that you try to do something different. You miss focus on the eyes
me.
A little bit.
Scares
maybe
me.
Because it's a self-portrait, but mm-hmm. It's really important to lock right in on those eyes or just use enough depth of field that everything's in focus. So you could just crank that f-stop up some. But cool mood.
Center me. Ooh.
This is really striking.
Very cool.
They are using a big ring light, which is a light that kind of encircles your lens. You put your camera through the ring light, and it creates a really interesting effect. They're using sunglasses to reflect that back and kind of make the light itself a really important part of the picture. And indeed, the ring light reflection is the first thing you see in the picture.
It reminds me of Lady Gaga and also the portrait that we did of Richard that time.
Yeah, when we were using our own homemade ring light. Like a little bit tighter crop there. I feel like that still kind of has all the same key elements. Oh, front bouquet. This is something I haven't worked a lot with, but I always really like the effect. It feels like you're looking through something almost like it's a candid picture and they just kind of spotted you.
Yeah.
I love this picture. I love the colors and how it all kind of blends together. Here's kind of a casual portrait done in natural light. What do you think, Jels? I think the lighting's beautiful. I love the background.
Yeah. It's tough with glasses because glare on the glasses, it's often difficult to get the focus on the eyes. Let's see. No, they got it. The glare is just a little bit distracting. But yeah, it's nice.
There's something about the tilt of her head that I want to change.
Oh.
I feel like her neck and head are just a little too linear.
Maybe.
Sorry, I was muted. I was saying I want to change the tilt of her head a little bit. Maybe have her tilt it forward a little bit or straighten it just a hair. You're doing some
just bringing up the shadows a little bit and just warming it up a little bit.
Yeah.
But I like it. She looks really natural, actually. That's like usually a very posy, like cheesy thing to do with your hand, but it actually looks like she was like that.
Yeah, I think it's a great portrait. It's also kind of dead center. You might move the subject off the side a little bit just to make it a little more compelling. Take a look at a couple more and then we'll get back to chit-chat.
I like this one.
Yeah, she has her forehead leaning in a little bit. It feels really engaging, especially with the eye contact. Camera's a little bit above eye line, but it almost feels like you're directly engaging her. Great shot, great processing, no distractions at all.
I think it's a selfie.
Oh, you think so? I almost wonder if it's spot color. Do you think they intentionally desaturated the background, or is that just the
don't tell me that.
The way it turned out? Well, you don't have to hate all spot color, Chels. You didn't notice it. It could just be that she has a really simple backdrop, but either way, turned out great.
Oh. It's a really nice picture, but I just have this weird thing with like drool and crusties for some reason. I can't handle it.
Yeah, it's kind of ever present on babies.
I know, it's just a baby thing.
Yeah.
But it's really nice. The picture is beautifully processed. The composition's nice. The focus is on the eyes.
I agree, it's a beautiful picture. The first thing I saw was the baby's drool. You could probably clone that out. It would take a little bit of work in Photoshop, but you could probably fix it if it bothers you. Maybe it's part of the story. Maybe that's part of the baby's character.
He's probably teething.
Something they want to capture.
Babies do that.
All right. We'll jump over into Chit Chat, where we read your comments aloud just to embarrass you.
Really? That's why you do it? Okay. Alex says, hi guys, awesome video. Thanks again, love this channel. So far so good. Would love to see how the A7 II handles focus tracking moving subjects on a perfect sunny day. The aquarium was in low light. Oh, so we kind of covered this earlier. We're gonna like field people's questions, and if you think we didn't test everything adequately, we'll go back and we'll redo a few tests so we can do that.
Yeah, we'll definitely follow up with this. I also wanna say in our videos, we tend to You tend to follow us on a single day while we kind of test out the cameras, but we've always been using the cameras prior to that.
Yeah.
And in this case, we've been using the A7 for quite some time. We used it for quite some time afterwards. So we kind of try to find scenarios where we can demonstrate what's going on because we don't want to bring Justin with us to like Thanksgiving and the kids' soccer game.
Well, one thing that he didn't see is that there was, when we were taking pictures of the penguins outside, it was in perfectly bright light.
Yeah.
And those weren't keeping up either.
Yeah, it's definitely better in bright light, and it's going to vary depending on the lens too. Mm-hmm. But
thank you for the video, Littlefinger. Someone called you Peter Baelish from Game of Thrones.
That's the first time I've gotten that, but I definitely see that.
I don't see that one.
Really?
And you know what I noticed?
He dyes anybody the with top, gray hair.
He dyes the top of his hair and leaves the sides gray.
How do you know he dyes it? Maybe that's natural.
It's not. I investigated further.
You really looked into this deep.
Yeah, I did. I zoomed. I really... And he dyes his mustache. I'm like, this guy's got skills.
Oh, I hate to even think. I mean, this takes place prior to the invention of Just for Men. So what do you think he is using for hair dye?
Cow dung.
Yeah. It's probably the souls of peasants.
Sigma 150 to 600 is the sharpest at the 600 end, beating the Canon Prime 400 millimeter. The price though, that's a 50-50. So he was really just kind of telling us more than a question, but I'm just saying like, we're gonna put that to the test and see if what you're saying is right.
Yeah, we're planning a big zoom showdown. We have the new Canon 100 to 400 Mark II, the Sigma 150 to 600, the sport version, the more expensive version, because the contemporary version is not yet available, and the Tamron 150 to 600 that we tested previously, and we'll throw in the 400 millimeter prime, because this guy mentioned it. Almost seems unfair. Everybody's like, how dare you compare a prime to a zoom? But if you're doing wildlife, you are kind of picking between them. The 400 prime beat the pants off the 150 to 600 last
time. I gotta say, I don't know why that's unfair. You're trying to take pictures of something. You're not out in the field like, I want to use my prime, but it's not fair to the zoom. You just want to get a picture, guys.
Yeah, it's all about results.
Life's not fair. I'm going to sit you down one day and I'm going to tell you.
It's unfair because they probably had already bought the zoom and they found out maybe they're not getting the sharpest results. Okay, if you want to submit your photos, maybe we'll get
time
for it.
We have some questions.
Oh, okay, go for it.
Jan Eric says, Tony, what brand of skin products do you use? But then he said, I bet Tony smears his skin with oil from dead babies each night for that perfect skin. We don't have perfect skin, we just have good lighting. Just walk around with a light and you'll be good.
Yeah, I don't know, whatever is cheapest at CVS. I'm not one of these picky people. What else you got, Chels?
He also said, Chelsea, what skincare line does Tony use? I must know.
Wow, he's really, I don't know. I can go to my shower later and figure out what's in there, but I'm not loyal to a particular brand. I'm not somebody who's thinking about it.
That's funny.
It's mostly just living the good, clean life, you know?
Campari. We don't really, here's a question from Mark. Why doesn't Nikkor have any F14s? I don't know. Do you know?
They don't have any F14s? There's not a Nikon 50 F14? I don't know, but there are lots of F14 lenses made by other companies. Maybe F14 is some sort of bad luck thing.
People want to know a lot about our faces today. Another person said they like my eyeshadow. You guys are into our faces, aren't you? Admit it. That's it.
Let's take a minute and look at a portfolio, because this episode is sponsored by Squarespace, and this portfolio is hosted on Squarespace.
I know that they use their Squarespace to make their logo, because I saw that one.
Oh, I want to show this off. Look, if you have a little window here, like a small monitor, look how neatly resized it. Go to a big screen monitor. It just shows you beautifully. And that's one of the nice things about Squarespace.
Tony.
It adapts to different formats, including mobile devices. So it looks like this portfolio is mostly made up of bands, which is kind of an awesome and one of the hardest parts of photography. People are always asking me, what kind of camera can I use? Too noisy, I can't get focusing. It is really hard.
Yeah.
I think your best bet is gonna be a full frame Nikon DSLR. The D750 or the D810 would kind of be ideal. Those are both very, very expensive.
We should ask, Benjamin Robson, because his photos look great.
Well, I'll just jump over those since I'm talking about it. Maybe he says what kind of sort of gear he has. He definitely has a Canon there. Yeah, I can't tell what that is because all Canon cameras look exactly the same. But your about page looks great. It's got your name there, some contact information, your email address and phone number. Let's look at his published work and see exactly what's done. Wow, he's all over the place. Yeah. Awesome. So both wildlife, and it looks like general photojournalism too. Nice. Check out some of his sports work. A little bit of everything here. For these photos, I would just suggest kind of revisiting the crop. And some of these, I think you could go a little bit tighter, like this one. There's a lot of kind of unused negative space up here.
That's a great one.
It is a really cool shot. I would just try to narrow it down to the subject and the object, like the athletes and the ball. Anyway, a little bit tighter crop. I know you can't pose people during sports, but you can do some of it in post. Let's jump back and see what Benjamin Robson had to say about this. Still trying to figure out Squarespace. Just made my site 2 days ago. I'd love to know what you would change. Some of my photos are still not on there yet, and I need to transfer over my domain. It looks like since he sent that in, he Oh, he didn't get his domain transferred over yet. They do give you a domain name for free, so you can register your name.com or whatever it is that you think it would work. I think as far as the homework goes, I think it looks really good. I suggested cropping some of those pictures, but you don't have too many pictures. You have a great about page with contact information. Seems like you went through the checklist and everything looks great.
Yeah.
We'll look at another Squarespace portfolio.
Ooh, this is so beautiful.
SB Photography. Yeah, this is an entirely different style of photography. It is kind of soothing and moody. Yeah, just gorgeous and peaceful shots.
Wow.
Jumping into a little bit of the gritty here. I love this reflection there, really nice. So here we have some black and white portraits, and yeah, only about 8 portraits. It's a really nice kind of selection of them. People in color. Those two pictures, a little too similar. I'd get rid of one of the keyboard pictures.
Really nice portraits.
Yeah. Yeah, not too many pictures. No obvious problems with any of them. I think they all look great. Street photography. Street style, I don't know what that means. Oh, okay. Fashionable people walking down the street. These look like they must be posed shots.
I don't know.
You think they're candid?
They're very Bill Cunningham. He just goes around New York City just kind of snapping people that look good.
That's what I thought at first too.
We love Bill Cunningham.
Travel photography. Lots of really rich colors here. This one might be a little too rich. I might just tone that down a little
bit.
Too
rich for our blood.
That one doesn't seem to have worked.
Oh, that's beautiful. I love the ships.
Yeah, and I love those clouds, too. That really caught my eye. Oh. So let's find out what SB's name here is. Read that for me, Chels.
I can't. I don't want to ruin it.
Okay, we'll stick with SB. SB, your website looks fantastic. We had a couple really minor suggestions, but overall, I think it's come together just great. You definitely don't have too many pictures. I actually don't mind the different categories here. I felt like it was a little rewarding to move through the different groups. What are you laughing at?
Nothing. I was trying to pronounce his name in my head, and things were getting weird up there. Okay, what did you have to say?
It's great and easy to use platform, perfect for my needs, talking about Squarespace. I know a lot of programming. I know a little programming, but with Squarespace, it's not worth the effort to do the programming.
Yeah, I agree.
I've been a programmer for a long time, too, and still I'd rather spend my time taking pictures and organizing them and editing them than writing HTML and such, and Squarespace lets you do that. You don't have to have any technical skills at all.
Even if you have technical skills, what are the odds that you have good design skills? And I found that the fact that they have some limitation, you don't have decision fatigue. You go in and everything kind of looks good together. It's hard to make it look ugly.
Yeah. So if you decide you want to set up a Squarespace portfolio for yourself, make your pictures look awesome, go to squarespace.com/Tony and use the coupon code PHOTONEWS. We'll take a look at some more pictures. Chelsea, do you have any more comments there?
Let me see. Someone, Bubble Boy, asked, should I consider going mirrorless after the T3i? I don't know. What do you take pictures of, Bubble Boy?
Yeah, and this is always the problem we have. People ask, what camera should I get? But they don't tell us what sort of work that they do. So for a lot of people, the answer is going to be yes. And for a lot, it's just no.
How many cameras do you guys use to make this video? Asked Anna. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah.
Six.
Sometimes six.
Six.
Yeah, Justin's GoPro isn't working right now, but yeah, usually 5 cameras.
We don't play around. Have you ever demoed the Zeiss 15mm for the Nikon?
No, I haven't used it.
No. That's it.
Okay. This is a really cool portrait.
It is, but very creepy, right?
Yeah, definitely. Even the hands are kind of like blended together. They've done something kind of cool rainbow effect with the eyes.
Yeah.
Yeah, you've been working with multiple exposures lately. I don't know what to say. It's cool.
It is cool.
I wouldn't change anything about it.
Beautiful. Let's see in that eye.
You just want to see if you can see him?
Yeah. Is he in nature?
Well, let's just crank the shadows up.
That's beautiful.
It is beautiful. I guess we'll call that a portrait. Great shot. Okay.
Let me zoom.
It's definitely a portrait. Another shot taken with a ring light. Or no. Is that a ring light? It looks like the sky. Actually, what on earth is going on with
the
lighting?
What is happening? We'll never know.
With the lighting?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's beautiful flat lighting. This is actually taken with an A7R, a mirrorless camera.
I thought that the skin looked too soft, but then I zoomed in and like, maybe she just has perfect skin?
I think it's been processed some, but it hasn't been overdone, I don't think. Yeah, it looks great. Feels like somebody is about to become a big brother, right? That kind of maternity shot.
Yeah.
I kind of want to go black and white with this.
Dang.
Then you got to look at the histogram here and we see the whites are a little low. So just bring it up so that there's some nice whites in there. Maybe drag the middles down here a little bit.
Too much.
Too much? That's really cute.
That is cute.
How do you feel about the depth of field? Should we get mom's eyes in focus as well?
No, I feel like this is good.
Yeah, it can. Usually the rule is you want everybody's eyes to be in focus. But here, clearly the focal point is on the baby's eyes. So, yeah, I think it's just fine. Nice shot. And as far as lines go, you can see that you do see her eyes, but they bring you right back to the baby.
Yeah.
So you do kind of spend most of your time looking at the baby.
I like this one.
Yeah, he's kind of a dark and moody portrait.
Wait. I might even just bring up the light on the rim of the hat here a little bit too. Like, I'm not going to have great control with this, but. Just to give a little more shape to the hat.
Yeah.
Now I'm overdoing it, but.
Let's hit Y to bring up the before and after.
Yeah. Love it.
Yeah, I do think this is a good case for kind of doing some dodging and burning. Looks really good. Get rid of the before and after.
Two babies. That baby's cute. We have the same haircut. Wow.
My first instinct was to crop down from the top a little bit, but at the same time, I really loved the light streaming through the grass behind her.
Yeah.
It might even be a good case where you'd want to kneel down a little bit lower, therefore kind of shifting the background so that the light was a little closer to her head, and you could move her head up a little bit more in the frame.
Yeah, the eyes just, or there's motion blur, I think.
Yeah, I do think it is motion blur. I have to reconfigure. Oh, 1/200th of a second. So there shouldn't have been.
Maybe it's a really fast baby.
Babies, you do actually have to use a faster shutter speed. She might have been moving a little bit.
It's cute still.
Yeah, but very cute shot. The lighting was just gorgeous.
Yeah, sometimes, it's beautiful lighting.
Sometimes you're opportunistic and you just say, hey, I have fantastic lighting. Let's go take a quick portrait. Oh, what a great angle. This is like a classic, what do you think, 7/8 or 3/4, between those two.
And she has beautiful bone structure and a nice smile.
Yeah.
Really natural.
Great background blur there. Yeah, just a great shot. You were clearly working with natural light, and you just did a really good job of it. Great background on it, too. This shot, we need some life in the eyes. Her eyes are completely black. And that ends up just being kind of spooky right away, don't you think? And I don't think they're going for spooky.
Yeah, but I love this picture still. Can you even get them?
Yeah, her eyes are in there.
I would do it because everything else looks good. I'd probably select them.
So it's always better to get this when you're taking the picture. And if you want to do that, you would. That's a good time to add a little bit of fill flash. Or you could position the subject a little bit differently so that there was a little bit of light in her face. But most of the time, I'll just add just a touch of fill flash, and that'll add a catch light and fix all your problems.
I didn't do it.
No, you already made it much better. Her eyes definitely came out quite a bit better than they were before.
It's like a stock photo.
I was going to say, this is exactly like a stock photo. iStock would probably complain that the pencils were not in focus. It never bothered me, but I know a stock photo agency might want everything in focus.
Yeah, it's still one nice picture. Oh, I know. They're really, really a pain.
Yeah, stock agencies are a pain. But the lighting on her face is just wonderful. The background looks perfect. Actually, the background is close to perfect, but I can see it's not quite. It doesn't matter, except that we're somehow, so for some reason, we're grading your picture as a stock photo.
Well, yeah, because it looks like one.
Yeah.
I actually like just a little bit of texture in
there. I was saying that, too, as I brought it down. I thought, actually, I like the texture in the background a little bit.
It just makes it a bit more natural.
Yeah, exactly. If you wanted to blend it into a web page or something, you'd probably want to go high key.
What do we have here? It's like a band picture, but yeah. He's the only one.
Yeah, and there's some motion to him. He's got his leg forward. He's moving towards us, and that adds a lot of intensity. If he were just standing there with his arms by his side, it would be really boring. What do you think the wristband means? Is he... Does he have a day pass to Disneyland, or did he go to a rave?
No. We don't know what this cool guy does. We've never been, like, that cool. I'm just giving it more mood, because he looks like he's up to something.
He does, and that something is posing in a beautiful field.
Yeah.
It's almost kind of a mixed mood, because his stance is kind of, like, badass, but he's in this, like, super
peaceful.
Romantic,
well, that's why I said it looks like
field.
a band photo.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah, I like it too. It's a good shot.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, it really is.
Perfectly sharp. Wow.
Yeah, you can see intense amounts of detail in her eyes.
I love it.
Yeah, beautiful shot.
Very cool.
All right, so this is kind of an environmental portrait of a pool player. I love the light and the shadows that you're casting across the pool table. Great use of rim lighting to tell the story and the subject. Fantastic shot.
Fantastic.
Using a D5200, by the way, which goes for like $300 or $400 nowadays, all the time we see some of the best shots that we see are with the least expensive gear, largely because these are people who aren't into the gear, but they're into the photography, and maybe they don't have a lot of money, but they get whatever they can, and they do a lot with it. This is just a great example of that. Perfect shot. Here we have a much more expensive camera, the D810, but the shot itself is really nicely processed.
Beautiful.
It's processed with kind of a high key style. I feel like the face might actually be a little
bright.
I
think it's a little bit, but maybe that's what they were going for, yeah.
They were going for that, but I think even going for that, it might be a bit much. I feel like the...
But the pose is beautiful, and you can see the line in the picture is just diagonal with the most, like, even negative space here.
Yeah.
It's a really beautiful composition.
How do you feel about the grain that they added to it?
I think it's interesting. It was clearly deliberate, so
yeah.
I'm cool with that.
Yeah.
And she's a beautiful model, too. I like it.
Yeah, great shot, great toning, good expression, everything about it. Good work on the hair, too, because that's something a lot of people mess up. Her hair could easily be completely black.
Yeah.
You might even benefit by showing a little bit more of the hair. I just did that to see if there was any hair in there. But you did a pretty good job with it. You could bring it down a little bit further, but you don't need to. Here's kind of it almost looks like a bridesmaid photo to me. She seems really cheery. She's posed in a pretty environment with flowers.
Yeah. It's a nice picture.
Yeah, it feels very candid. I almost want to use the, like, whitened teeth adjustment brush and clean it up a little bit. A little bit of processing on the skin. But it would be fine as is, too. It doesn't really need anything. It's a great shot. Great light on it, too. I feel like this is another environmental shot, kind of telling the story of a hiker, I guess. Love those mittens. What's she got in a little bag there?
Cookie Monster in disguise.
He's got a human mask on as he's sneaking around.
I don't know. Maybe that's
not. Thought it might be a camera or something. It's probably completely unrelated. Yeah, cool shot. Inner environment in the woods. Mm-hmm. Nicely done. Wow. Not a portrait. Gorgeous. It's not a portrait. Portrait of a musician, again at a pool table, but that's kind of where they hang out. He's in Spider-Man. Maybe black and white?
Let's see.
What do you think?
I like the black and white, but the color, I think, brings out his shirt and tattoos more. I don't know if they wanted to go for that. Brings out the pool table a little more, too. But I think, for me, the black and white, I'm focusing on his eyes and his hands on the neck on the guitar. So I would prefer that, but...
Yeah, you're right. They do tell completely different stories. Mm-hmm. The color photo and the black and white photo, you don't even know he's at a pool table. Because it just, you lose that part of the story. The green is kind of an important, the green felt tells us where he is. So if the location is important, you're going to have to keep that green in there. If it's about him and the location doesn't matter, then I would go for the black and white shot. I found the Spider-Man thing kind of distracting, but I did like that you could see the color in his tattoos. Wow. This is a really cool shot. Just wanted to check the exposure time here. 13 seconds.
Not a portrait, but still cool.
Yeah, you're right. It's not necessarily about the person. He's almost kind of posing in a landscape, adding a focal point to it. But it does have a person. It is really tough to get to include a person in one of these long exposures. And you did a great job with it. They're always going to end up a little blurry because who can hold truly still for 13 seconds?
You're a very still person.
I can be a really still person, but I would still... This guy's a still person, too. He really is, especially with his neck kind of tilted back like that. They included him in the landscape to kind of tell the story of the sky. Let's see what we have here. Wish I could see your f-stop number, but...
13 seconds.
Yeah. Turned out great. Just a beautiful, beautiful portrait. I almost want to fool with... Oh, did you just fool with the...
Yeah, I did that. Yeah. Why don't you see the before and after?
Ah, yeah. I like it a little more towards the blue. The green somehow felt a little unnatural, but at the same time, make it look like whatever your eye sees. Baby, with some real intense eyes on this kid.
Oh my goodness, yeah. Those are so blue.
Got a nice light on him. I think good shot. I don't really have any suggestions. Maybe go tighter on the eyes. Speaking of tighter on the eyes, there you go.
That's a handsome baby.
Yeah, it is, and it's a great shot. This was clearly a portrait shoot because no baby wears a bow tie on its day-to-day life.
Oh, there are babies.
Maybe Bill Nye, maybe, but...
You love Bill Nye. Actually, you like that fake ghetto Bill Nye on Twitter.
Bill Nye, though?
Yeah.
My favorite Twitter guy.
Every time I look over, you're laughing at that.
Bill Nye, though.
These are cool shots.
Okay, so they snuck two pictures in one, but I'll give you credit for it. So these are clearly fitness shots. She looks like she's a bodybuilder. She has a lot of muscle. I think they're both great. The shot on the left has kind of a grittier feel to it.
I like the shot on the left. Like, I feel like she's going to beat me up. She's going to beat you up, and I like that in a woman.
Yeah, the shot on the left here is kind of making her look tough. And they convey it with the pose, and even the outfit is kind of studded.
Yeah.
And on the right here, it's more of like a classic beauty glamour shot with the backlighting.
I like them both.
Yeah.
But I think the one on the left is like more artistic and more original.
Yeah. Yeah, agreed. But they each have their own kind of roles, and you support that mood through the pose and the lighting and the expression and the outfit even.
I love this moment that they captured.
Yeah,
that's
sweet.
It's so pretty. Love it. How's your drink?
Good. I like this a lot.
You do?
Yeah. I would probably put more beer in it next time. I'd follow the actual recipe.
You feeling it?
Beautiful shot.
Yeah, it's
not a portrait.
Not a portrait. Oh, this one's candid.
Surely we can get people to put their phones down for portraits nowadays.
No, we can't.
I do like her expression, but yeah, we'd have to crop that down a little bit just to get rid of the phone.
You know what? He looks like, he looks fake, right? You know when they like use someone's DNA and then recreate what they look like?
I don't think that has ever happened, Chelsea.
Yeah, they do. I just saw something about it. It's basically that. You'll see. I'll show you later.
Justin's the science guy. Justin, you tell us, can they take somebody's DNA and recreate what they look like?
I've not heard of that.
Yeah. That seems like a stretch. You could take somebody's skeleton. Like, you can find a caveman skeleton and build it up. But so I don't know about this poor guy. I feel like somebody submitted their picture. And now we're saying it looks like a recreation of a person. He's an actual person.
I felt like, but I'm looking for it.
Black and white worked a little bit better. He's got a very, he's centered in the frame and just very straight, and he has just no expression. So it depends. I feel like this is an author shot, and sometimes they have a particular mood they want to convey, like really serious, but a little bit of head tilt, even away from the camera, a masculine tilt or a little bit towards the camera would help. Or even tilting the forehead a little bit in would make it a little more intense. And maybe just having him think about a particular emotion. Wait. Now you're trying to find this?
Smithsonian Magazine. Creepy or cool, portraits derived from the DNA and hair and gum found in public places. An artist slash scientist took DNA from the streets and then recreated people's portraits using them.
Did they have sample pictures?
Yes, but now I feel bad because I said that guy looked like one.
Well, how can I find it?
Well,
I'm sorry to have to pause the show here, but
that doesn't mean it's a precise replica of him either.
What's the name, the title of it?
Oh. Creepy or Cool, Portraits Derived from the DNA and Hair and Gum, smithsonian.com. Okay. It says gun. But like this, they're not showing the whole head, so I feel bad, but they look very still, like that guy.
That's her DNA-derived self-portrait. Well, that doesn't seem fair. I feel like she should create somebody's portrait without knowing what they look like, and then they should bring the person out. She already knows what she looks like, right?
Wait, do they?
How is that fair?
I don't think, do they? Because what would be the point of, like, how would you find a piece of gum in the streets and then track the person down? Oh, because they never know what that person looks like.
Well, yeah, I'm curious to see whether it's accurate, though, and she can't put a picture of herself up with her own face and be like, it's accurate. That's not a blind test.
Well,
she's seen a mirror before.
Test her. Let's send her our gum.
Okay, so send her our gum. I bet she's getting just bags of gum every day from the Postal Service now.
I'm just saying, you guys laugh.
I see what you mean.
You get it now, right?
Okay, so we're saying get a little more expression out of them. Dark shirts like that can be a little tough. You might have to go in and retouch the darkness on it to clean it up a little bit. Really cute baby Christmas shot here. I want to bring the shadows up in the eyes just a little bit, something we often end up doing. Just crank that up a little,
make the eyes pop
a little bit. So
that is cute.
As we look at the before and after, you can see just having the eyes pop a little bit does make a pretty big difference. Otherwise, just great shot. I said that, and then I'm like, I really want to crop this a little bit. So by cropping it just a little bit, I feel like we kind of tell the same story, but there was other kind of background elements that were a little bit distracting to me. Same baby, one shot per person. That is a cute shot. What do you think, Chels?
I like it.
That's all you got? We could talk about the pose or something?
Well, this is what I like
about
it.
There's something I want to do different about the head, and you're kind of the expert in posing, so tell me how she should have posed, because there's something weird about her angle. I can't quite put my finger on it.
I think it's just the way the lighting is hitting her chin, because you have that lit space on her neck. I think that's what's kind of throwing you off, because cover that with your hand.
Yeah, you bring up a good point. So part of it is you have a deep shadow here and a deep shadow here, and then just really hard light here. You can fix that by raising the light up a little bit so her chin casts a little more shadow.
Yeah. But I do like I like just a little bit of the background you can see to give you context. I like that she's looking into like the negative space. I like that she's styled kind of bohemian and different. I get tired of seeing the same styling over and over again. It's good.
Yeah. The outfit is great.
The light is a little harsh, though.
Yes, you're right. Overall, the light is just a little harder than we might like. You fix that by using a bigger light source. You can diffuse it, but that basically just bounces the light off of other elements in the room. It doesn't necessarily make the light any bigger.
Yeah.
You can also move a light source just closer to the person and then crank the brightness down. That effectively makes it a bigger light source. Really nice pose. I like the tight crop and the rule of thirds composition. What is up with all the noise in the picture? Maybe that's just the native noise in the camera, but it can not look great on skin. It's like you're adding texture to the skin. So this is some place where I'd want to just smooth the, really crank the noise reduction up, just so the noise doesn't give her like rough skin. You can see there's still some of that. I don't think the color will make any difference, but. Okay, just something to think about.
The guy said that he can explain the light setup for that picture.
Oh, is he going to? He's just bragging that he can.
I'll tell him.
Okay. Definitely going to need your take on this picture.
All I see is boobs.
Yeah.
We get it.
Okay, so there are some boobs.
No, but other than that, I like the little look. I like the styling. It's like 60s. Her shirt's cute. I like the look over the glasses, but her eyes aren't really perfectly in focus, which, well, I'm a woman, but I think that should be the focus of the picture. I think her boobs are sharper than her eyes, which is just kind of, it's a little weird. But yeah.
I guess I want to see a little bit more expression from her, too. Her chin might be a little closer to her neck. You could have her hold
her whole head out. Yeah, she's tucking her chin. It's giving her a little wrinkle on the neck.
Yeah, just have her push her whole head forward a little bit.
I'm trying to think how you would peek over your glasses and not, like, squish your chin. Because most people want to put their chin up, not push it down.
Yeah, it's the subtleties of posing that can make or break a picture. But they're also really difficult for us to kind of convey looking at a picture afterwards.
The guy said it's a pop-up ring flash, like a diffuser. It looks like a drum. Another person brings up that she was showing off her armpit.
Oh, this
I love armpits.
Which picture?
The girl looking over the glasses.
Oh.
Yeah, but that's not. Everybody has. You gotta have an armpit.
The lighting here is very, very hard. So you have these like deep contrasty shadows, and that can work if you're making like a deep and moody picture, but this is a happy, like upbeat photo, and I think I'd rather see like bright, soft lighting.
Christmas is a hard time of year for a lot of people.
But they all have big smiles, even the little elf. The elf is the only one who has like flattering light on his face. So a bigger light source really helps with that, and I suspect this was taken with a single off-camera flash.
Yeah.
What I would do in that situation is just turn the flash around, point it at the ceiling, just use a bounce flash. That'll give you much softer light. You can't really aim lighting too precisely with group shots anyway, because it's kind of impossible to get everybody perfectly lit. So bounce that flash,
you can see.
Is what I'm saying.
Bounce it.
Yeah. And don't be afraid to crank up the noise reduction a little bit.
Cool.
All right. Nice and gritty shot.
So I just want to make it clear. There was nothing wrong with the way that the very still guy looked that I said looked like the DNA thing.
Uh-huh.
Other than he looked like he was just very like a deer in headlights. And this guy just has like an expression, you know. He's just like a bro hanging out, smoking. So that's the difference. I feel like they captured a moment with this guy. With the other guy, he looked fine, but I felt like he was very like, oh my gosh, I'm in a picture. And just like froze. That's kind of the difference.
What I find is that people focus on what gear should I get? What lighting should I get?
Yeah.
What focal length should I use? All the camera settings, all this stuff. The single most important part of a portrait is going to be the pose and expression of the model. The second most important thing is going to be the lighting. But you can have a photo with just a great expression and terrible everything else, and it will come across great.
Maybe.
Maybe not terrible everything else, but okay everything else. So a lot of people need to work on their kind of expressions, and that involves talking to the models and bringing the right expressions out of them. And then figuring out how to give them kind of subtle direction.
It's easy when posing. You have this guy.
This guy is, well, maybe he's not a natural model. Maybe he's been practicing for some time. But yeah, he is an awesome model.
He looks like a natural to me.
But yeah, you try to get the right mood inside of them by maybe joking with them or whatever your rapport with them is. Sometimes I often will be taking pictures and Chelsea will be doing the chatting. I find that to be the most challenging part of portraiture is dealing with the technical aspects, but also trying to keep up your chit chat and get them in the right mood. Sometimes you have to steer the conversation to something that will get the right mood from them. Anyway, it helps a lot if you know the subject and that they're comfortable. I find often when you tell them to tilt their head like this, you'll shatter the entire mood. Suddenly they start to think about their body and they become all awkward.
Unless it's an experienced model that knows their angles, I don't even bother because they'll be like happy and then like, all right, now just tilt your head 3/4. And they're like, like, no, go back to what you were doing.
It's like if you're walking and somebody said, oh, you're walking normal. Then suddenly like, you'd be like,
eh. My legs don't work. I've had that happen. You're like, I forgot. Yeah, it's tough. But this guy clearly, he just hangs out like that.
Yeah, he's a bro. So this has been News, Booze, and Reviews. We're here every Thursday at 5 o'clock.
I missed it so much.
Do you have any other comments for us? Did anybody have anything interesting to say? Nothing today?
Someone said there's a 30-second delay in case Chelsea has a full vagina slip. Call back. I'm trying to subscribe to what Eric Kim says. Buy books, not gear, but it's hard when you geek out about new cameras and lenses. You should not buy books. You should buy our books.
Yeah, just three books. Mm-mm, that's all you need. I think it's okay, too, that people find the gear to be the fun part of photography. That's fine. Whatever gets you into the art of it. It's all right. It's not all about taking pictures. What's making you cover your mouth now?
I can't even read that.
Okay. You got anything else, or are we signing out?
Wait, let me see. They're always saying something really inappropriate. No, I don't know. I wish everyone could read the comments once we post the video, because they go away.
Yeah.
But
It is weird that the comments go away.
So well, anyway.
We'll see you next week.
Did we do mid-roll?
Yeah, we did.
Good. So but we did everything.
Regardless, thank you to Squarespace, our sponsor. They make awesome portfolios.
They make
pictures look just awesome, and they make this possible.
Oh, yeah. You should get our Lightroom book so we can be number one.
Yep.
Shameless. Shameless.
You can go to Amazon or scp.io/store to check out our books. Just search for Tony Northup at Amazon. If you want your Squarespace portfolio, go to squarespace.com/Tony and use the coupon code PHOTONEWS, and otherwise, we will see you in 1 week. Thanks, guys.
Bye.